One's down there, and one's right here. Okay, I'm just gonna be gentle. Pull it right out of that hole. Okay, and that.
This is the 1 inch for the riser. Two pieces of pipe together.
Repipe this meter. This meter's functioning and working. The gas company has removed this side because of major leaks, and it was beyond repair. So here I am. If you're looking for this, you're in the right spot. I'm gonna show you how I do this. So first off, you wanna make sure you've dug. I've dug down below the meter. I've done all the digging. I've cut out the roots and I've exposed my pipes. Okay, so that's the first step. You wanna find the depth of your pipe and uncover the 90, this elbow that connects onto your meter. Okay, from there, it's just running straight pipe down your ditch that you dug. And I got a whole video on how I got this far. If you wanna check that out, I'll link it at the end of this video. But you're just gonna run your straight pipe all the way down this ditch. Not a whole lot going on there except for a couple of fittings. And then down here, the rest of your fittings are gonna be on the other end. And this is where it kicks into my house. So I've dug down right here and I've exposed the 90 at the bottom. I've found the depth all the way throughout. And I would suggest hiring a professional to do all this. I'm gonna show you how I do this. So stay close. Here's where you turn the meter off, get you a crescent wrench, close it down to the size you need it to be, and then give it a good crank. Horizontal, like it is right now, is turned off. If it's up and down, it's turned on. Like this one is turned up and down, it's vertical. This is on, make sure that it's off. This is the meter that I'm working on. First things first, make sure you've got your doctor on hand. Okay? Get that pipe laid in the ground. I've got all of it laid in the ground, all the way down
okay,
the
Okay, so here's a little parts list. I've got four 90s, three couplings. I actually have four, one's over there. I'm gonna show you how to hook it up. But this is what we're doing right now. This is the coupling, 1¼ inch. And these are 1¼ inch 90s. So that's pretty much all this project consists of. You know, and a couple of little things here and there. Different size. These are 1-inch 90s. And these are little pieces of pipe that we may or may not need. I'm not gonna take them out of the bags unless I need them. But these are little pipe extensions if we need that. So let's get to work.
Okay, I've got my two 10-foot sticks of pipe. This side has that 90 that goes up to the meter. And this side is continuing to the house. So let's see how we connect this together with one of these couplings. Make sure you don't get any dirt inside the pipe or on your fittings. Just be gentle. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do is take this Blue Monster tape. You can see how I have this, hold it in my left hand, and then I get it started. And once it's started, get it around there the first time. And then I've got my finger through the middle there and I'm just going around. You want to go around a few times. Down. Get you some Blue Monster pipe dope. Get the access off. And then put your coupling on. This doesn't have to be super thick. It just needs to be on there, an even layer. And make sure you don't get any of that inside the pipe as well. This stuff's very sharp, so don't cut your fingers. Now let's put this on here, righty tighty. Don't cross thread it. Now, before I hook up this piece, I'll be right back. I gotta shake the dirt out of this pipe.
Cut out on me. The video camera overheated, so here I am again with a new piece. All I'm gonna do is go on the other end of this 10-foot stick and I'm gonna push it into that coupling and I'm gonna push it in by hand. So let's get it started.
Now
I'm gonna crank this up.
Here's the one I've cut. All I've done is I've taken my Sawzall and I've cut the pipe. You see, I've cut it in two different spots. Once down there and once right here. And I gotta show you, I think you can see this, but this is full of water. So, anyway, that old line is full of water. And what I've done is I've cut that out. Now that I've removed this, this is dropped down. But you see, I need this piece right here, this little U, and this piece that goes to the city. I'm gonna still need that. But before you do, cut all this, and I already did, I made some measurements right here, and I've got that my riser needs to be 26 inches from right here, which you can see I've installed the 90 here and a reducer from 1 1/4 down to 1 inch. And this is just temporary to keep dirt out of the pipe. I left it like this overnight and put a little cap on the end. You don't want to get any dirt inside this pipe at all. I'm going to get to these fittings. This was really simple though. All this is a 1 1/4 inch down to a 1 inch reducer. You can find that at your Lowe's or whatever hardware store. And then this is a 90. And all this is in between is a little 1 foot stretch of pipe. And you can buy that also at your local hardware store, and or some of them. You might have to shop around. And then I've got a stick right here. This is a 10-foot stick of 1 1/4 inch pipe, and so on and so forth. Very simple. So that's all that is. So once you got that cut out, and the reason that this is 1 1/4 and it goes down to 1 inch is because at the city it's 1 inch, and then it reduces up and it goes up to a 1 1/4 inch. So I don't know everything, but I do know that. I know that it's supposed to do that. So now that we're 1 1/4 inch, that's all we did to get to that size. This is gonna be tricky though, to get inside that old hole. And before you remove this one out, make sure that you get the measurements, the exact measurement that it needs to be at the exact height that it was before, this height right here.
I don't like
it where it's gonna connect down here.
Thank you.
That spot, get that measurement, because it's gonna have to be the exact as it was before. So that's pretty crucial, that's important. But now that I've cut that and got that loose, I'm gonna pull it out now. One that's an 18 inch, and one that is a 14 inch. And I'm gonna disconnect the city piece. Okay, I've got the city piece.
Okay.
And this is not gonna be here. This is just to keep dirt out of the pipe for right now. So I'm gonna remove this. Be very gentle not to get any dirt in the pipe. This is gonna slide back in a new piece of pipe that I'm gonna have Lowe's cut with their little pipe threading machine. It's free at Lowe's. I'm gonna have them cut 3 pipes to length that I need.
This one.
Going for now with the couplings because I don't have that piece cut yet from Lowe's. Order in. This is the 1 inch for the riser at that end. And then this is the 3 foot piece where I was short to the house. And this is the riser for the house end. So let's get these two hooked up first. This 90 is facing upwards. I've got the pipe dope and the tape. Now I'm going to stick this riser inside this 90. Now
I'm gonna finish tightening it to straighten it up. Now I'm gonna put this cap back on so that the rain doesn't get inside it and no dirt gets inside there. Here's the hole that we need to pop up. Here's that special cut piece from Lowe's. I've got it pipe doped and taped. I'm gonna remove this section right here and we're gonna tie into that 1 1/4 inch with this 1 inch piece. On the other end, all it is laid down the hole and you can see it sticking up on the other end down there. All it is, 1 1/4 inch pipe to a 1 1/4 inch 90, coming out 1 1/4 inch, 1 foot up to a 1 1/4 to a 1 inch reducer, and then right through the old hole, right there. It's in the exact same spot, may need to go over about an inch or two. You can see I had to widen that hole out so I didn't get dirt inside the pipe, so I got some playroom right here. And I'll get this top piece on here, show you how I do that, and then how to hook into the house on the other end. See, here I am on the other end, and all I've done is cut that 1 1/4 inch pipe, that 90 up, and it used to connect into right here, okay? And this pipe, if you want to check out my other videos, I'll link a playlist at the end of this video, but this is connected inside all flexible home flex gas line, and I've shown you how to do everything inside. But all this is a union, and basically it's just a little fitting from the store, and it pulls these two pieces of pipe together. And that's the final piece. This is the very last piece that you're going to want to do. You're going to want to put this in first, and this 90, this is just a little couple of inches threaded pipe so that I can connect this 90 to this union and this union to this inside pipe. Okay, this is a 90, another 90, and another 90, okay? That's all it is now. The pipes are coming inside right here, and I'm gonna paint everything, probably with gray paint or something, maybe orange. You could even do black, but I'm probably gonna paint this with a spray can, okay? And there's the old piece, and in order to get this off, I had to use my pipe wrenches. And I had to use this big 1 1/4 inch bar as a cheater bar. It's a few feet long, and I put that over my pipe wrenches to bust this 90 loose. So it was a little tricky. And the reason I'm explaining this last part to you is because there's no evidence that I did it. I could be blowing smoke for all you know. I didn't do this. I never hooked this union to the house. I never did. Okay, and let me show you the other end. What I did here is just get your pipe set up through here, and the city piece would go on there, see? And now we're back in action and ready to call for them to put that in. But I'm going to make a whole other video on how to air it up and test it before you bury your lines up, which I'm working on. I'm actually going to do a 24-hour to 48-hour test, so I'll be back with you on that. So follow along, but all this is a 90, and then under here, it reduces right there. It reduces from 1 1/4 to 1 inch and goes through the old hole. Right here, it comes up through the old hole, and then you'd put the city piece on top of that after checking it. But this video has gotten too long, so if this video is helpful in any way, go ahead and like it. Subscribe to my channel if you like home improvement videos. I'm going to the lake. Throw it over that mountain. Ooh! Yeehaw!